Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
And so on and so forth, we eventually got the idea of gathering in this place for more than just shopping. It became the administrative, the legislative, and the religious center of Rome. And that's what we're going to be exploring, this space which really was the heart and the core of ancient Rome. All right? So let's...
Epistles, and he wasn't living, speaking in English and living in a democracy. He was living in the Roman Empire. He knew what we're seeing today and talking about was the way he lived, not something he learned about that happened in the past. He lived it every day. And I love when I read in the book of Colossians, it talks about how Jesus did so much on the cross for us. All the decrees that were against us, he tore down and he dismissed them. He's talking legal terms. He's talking about what's going on right here in the Forum with all these legal aspects. It's Jewish, yes, it's that too, but he's also referring to the kingdom of Rome. And listen to what he says. He disarmed the principalities and powers and made a public example of them triumphing over them in Christ or in his cross. And so what happened when the Romans would take over a country, when they would go into a new area and they would fight in battle, and they would capture the king, they would capture the queen and all of his sons and daughters and all of the royalty and all of their senate and all of their important and rich people, and he would bring them to Rome, and that general would march right up this road, take them all the way to the other end of that forum where the great rostrum was, and there all of the enemy that he had conquered had to march in front of the parade, in chains. So some great king in another land who was just ruling his own empire now comes through Rome in chains, completely humiliated, completely destroyed. All of his wealth, all of his treasures are being processed along with him that Rome now handles. And like Liz says, Cleopatra refused to be humiliated, to humiliate Egypt in her person, so she would rather commit suicide than be marched through the city to be made fun of, and to have all the Romans, if you can imagine them, all lining the street, cheering the great general who defeated this country and is bringing all of these wealth and all of the enemy, processing them in the front all the way up there to be completely humiliated and triumphing over them. And what is this? This is an arch of triumph. And when a general would come, when Titus came, forms and all these others. So when you come here and you think about this, what is it telling us? Well, Jesus conquered evil. He conquered sin. He conquered the law that was opposed to us, that held us guilty before God. And he conquered the devil. And Paul always uses this terminology. Ephesians chapter 6 says we wrestle, that we war not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers. And he talks about the armor that we're supposed to wear and the shield of faith and the sword of the Spirit and doing battle. This is all Roman language of what happened right here in this forum. Tear down strongholds, and we bring every thought into captivity to Jesus Christ. This is all what we're seeing here. Bringing everything into captivity to Rome. Rome is going to rule over the world. But what do we do as Christians? We are to fight against them.
We're on our way through the Colosseum. We just went through the restroom area, which is always a chore. And now we're on our way through the columns, and we're going to be going in just a moment. And here comes the group.
Colosseum, having a wonderful time. Hello to all the family, and Melissa and Dan and everyone, and hope to see you here soon. So they blew in my eyes.
To make his witness, I believe in Jesus Christ. I'm not going to sacrifice to others. I'm not going to sacrifice to you. That's the big moment. What happens from that moment on isn't really important. The only time we really hear about where people die, we'll talk about this tomorrow and the next day, because it's unusual. St. Agnes was killed in So we know these things because they're unusual. But having somebody die in this place of public execution doesn't make any sense at all. And I'm going to top that with a description of a public execution for you, because we actually do know the public executions took place here. It's the middle.
Underground, where they kept all the animals and the prisoners. They would come up in elevators to the top, right here, where they would then die.
Hi, Mom and Dad, this is Steve. I know you're staying at our house with Jesse and Ann and the girls, and wanted to just say hello from Rome. Right over there is St. Peter's. That's where the church built over the bones of St. Peter. We just wanted to say we love you. Bye-bye.
But we're always asked to do what God wants us to do in His strength. He doesn't ask us to find the reserves inside of ourselves. How could, you know, just, if I could just be a little more patient or a little more peaceful or a little more